Hello students, this video is my continuation of my previous video on pelvic floor muscles. Okay, in my previous video I talked about piriformis muscle and obturator internus muscle. In this video I will continue with the next group of muscles, that is the levator ani. Okay, in my previous video I have talked about this levator ani and I have divided ischiococcygeus, iliococcygeus and pubococcygeus. Okay, so I'll describe this group of muscles in this video. Okay, now pelvic diaphragm, this the levator ani and the coccygeus muscles of the two sides form a transverse partition across the pelvis, which is called pelvic diaphragm. So the levator ani and the coccygeus muscles of the two sides, okay, levator ani and the coccygeus. So though levator ani consists of coccygeus, but they are taken sometimes separately also. So levator ani consists of iliococcygeus and pubococcygeus, and next muscle is the coccygeus. Okay, so levator ani consists of iliococcygeus and pubococcygeus, and separately the coccygeus muscle. Okay, you can describe it anyway. Now, so both these muscles, they form the pelvic diaphragm. Please see this diagram. This is the arrangement of levator ani and coccygeus muscle. Okay, so this muscles of the two sides, okay, right and left side, they forms the transverse partition across the pelvis. So it forms the transverse partition across the pelvis. Okay, it is lying transversely, so it will form pelvic diaphragm. These four muscles are enclosed in the superior and inferior layers of the fascia of the pelvic diaphragm. Okay, so they are enclosed in the pelvic diaphragm, fascia of the pelvic diaphragm. So pelvic diaphragm includes levator ani and the coccygeus muscles. This could be asked in your short note. The diaphragm is funnel shaped and separates the pelvic viscera above from the structures in the perineum and the ischiorectal fossa. So it will separate the pelvic viscera above and the structures in the perineum. What are the structures in the perineum? What is the pelvic viscera? The vagina, the prostate gland, okay, the urethra. These are all the pelvic viscera. And what are the structures in the perineum? The anum, anal canal, the rectum. So it will, this pelvic diaphragm will separate the viscera above, viscera above, and the structures in the perineum. Okay, and the ischiorectal fossa. The pelvic diaphragm is pierced by the rectum, the urethra, and in the female by the vagina. So now we'll talk about this levator ani and coccygeus muscle. Okay, first we'll take the first muscle, that is the coccygeus muscle. Okay, now first we'll describe what is levator ani. Levator ani is a broad muscular sheet attached to the internal surface of the true pelvis and forms a large portion of the pelvic floor. Okay, so levator ani is a broad muscular sheet attached to the internal surface. Okay, it's a broad muscular sheet which is attached to the internal surface of the true pelvis. So if you see this, it's a internal surface of the true pelvis, the broad muscular sheets. You can see here, these are all muscles which are forming the true pelvis and forms a large portion of the pelvic floor. Though the muscle is subdivided into named parts depending on the attachments of these parts. So this muscle is divided upon various parts. Various names have been given to the muscles, but together they are pelvic floor muscles. And these names are given depending on the attachment of these muscles. On which part of the pelvic girdle this muscle is attached, the name is given accordingly. The boundaries between each part cannot be clearly distinguished, but you cannot distinguish the each part. The individual parts of the levator ani muscle are ischiococcygeus or coccygeus, iliococcygeus and pubococcygeus. So this I have talked here only. The individual part is coccygeus और ischiococcygeus as the name, ischium and coccyx. Now which part of the ischium, that we'll see. Ileococcygeus means ileum and coccyx. Which part of the ileum and coccyx, we'll see. And pubococcygeus. So it has three fibers, which I have already mentioned. So first muscle we'll take here is ischiococcygeus. Okay, we'll take ischiococcygeus. So if you see here, ischiococcygeus, this muscle is also called coccygeus. Okay, this muscle is also known as coccygeus muscle. It is the posterior superior part of the levator ani muscle and is triangular muscular tendinous sheet. The sacrospinous ligament is considered to be a degenerate part of the ischiococcygeus muscle. So the first muscle of the levator ani group of muscle or the pelvic diaphragm is the ischiococcygeus or the coccygeus. It is ischiococcygeus, the other name is coccygeus. Now first we'll take the origin. What is the origin of this muscle? What is the origin of ischiococcygeus? It is from the pelvic surface of the tip of the ischial spine. Okay, so it is from the pelvic surface, from the tip of the ischial spine. Okay, this is ischiococcygeus or the coccygeus muscle. So it is also known as coccygeus. It is on both the sides. So if you see this diagram, this is coccygeus, this is the ischial spine. Okay, so it is arising from the pelvic surface of the tip of the ischial spine. So if you take this diagram, this is, I'm seeing from above. Okay, I'm seeing from above. If I'm holding the pelvic girdle, I'm seeing from above the floor muscles. So from above, if I'll see, this is coccygeus. So this is the ischial spine. Yes, these are the ischial spine as is shown in the diagram. These are the ischial spines. Okay, so coccygeus is arising from the ischial spine. Okay, this is triangular. Okay, that also they have described. So this is triangular. So coccygeus, this is coccygeus. This muscle is coccygeus muscle. Okay, this is coccygeus. Yes, this triangular shaped muscle is coccygeus. Okay, as you can see, and it is triangular in shape. The pelvic surface of the tip of the ischial spine, the origin is from the tip of the ischial spine. This is ischial spine. And the insertion is base of the muscle is attached to the lateral margins of the coccyx and fifth sacral segment. So it is attached to the lateral margins of the coccyx. Lateral margins of the coccyx and the fifth sacral vertebra. So S5 and the lateral margins of the coccyx is the attachment. The attachment to coccyx is by fibrous band called the anococcygeal ligament. Okay, so anococcygeal ligament. So this was about the coccygeus. Okay, this was about the coccygeus muscle. Yes, so it is from, if you see here this one more diagram, okay, coccygeus muscle. Okay, you can see here the ischial spine, from the ischial spine to the S5 vertebrae and also the lateral part of the coccyx. Okay, the lateral margins of the coccyx. This is coccygeus. Okay, so this is about the coccygeus muscle. Okay, if you take from here also, so this is pubococcygeus or ileococcygeus levator ani. Okay, now the coccygeus muscle. Okay, so here it was, insertion is from the tip of the ischial spine. Okay, is here. The tip of the ischial spine to the sacral vertebrae S5 and the lateral half of the coccyx. This is your coccygeus muscle. Okay? This is your coccygeus muscle. Okay? So this is ischiococcygeus. Ischiococcygeus means from the ischial spine to the lateral margins of the coccyx. From ischial spine to the lateral margins of the coccyx. Okay, so that was about your coccygeus muscle. Okay, one more diagram I'll show. This is coccygeus. This is the ischial spine. So from the ischial spine to the tip of the from the ischial spine to the coccyx, lateral margin of the coccyx and the lateral surface of the S5. Okay, so this is about the coccygeus muscle. Okay, clear? Now, the next muscle we have to take into consideration is the iliococcygeus. Okay, we'll take the iliococcygeus. So if you see here, there is no muscles here. So if you see, if I draw this way, this is the ischial spine. Okay, so from ischial spine to S5, okay, and the lateral margins of the coccyx. Okay, so this is ischiococcygeus. From, you can see here very nicely without any muscles, if I draw, this is the ischial spine, tip of the ischial spine to the sacral vertebrae S5 and the lateral half of the or lateral margins of the coccyx. So this is your ischiococcygeus muscle. You can see ischiococcygeus muscle. Clear? Now, the next muscle is iliococcygeus. We can see the next muscle is the iliococcygeus. So this part of the muscle is thin and aponeurotic. This part of the muscle is thin and aponeurotic. Origin, from the pelvic surface of the ischial spine below and to the and anterior to the attachment of the ischiococcygeus. It's a tendinous arch of levator ani up to the obturator canal. Now we'll take the next muscle. Okay, we'll take the next muscle. That is the iliococcygeus. Okay. Now, iliococcygeus, if you see here in the diagram, I'll show. Okay, this is iliococcygeus. Yes, you can see this is coccygeus and this is iliococcygeus. And see here, this is iliococcygeus. This muscle. Okay, so this muscle is from the ischial spine, okay, below and anterior to the attachment of the ischiococcygeus. So it is anterior to ischiococcygeus. This is ischiococcygeus or coccygeus. It is anterior to ischiococcygeus, okay, and it is ischial spine, okay, from the ischial spine. Tendinous arch of the levator ani up to the obturator canal. And also you can see the posterior half of the obturator fascia. Now you can see this white line. This white line is the obturator fascia, or it is also known as white line or tendinous arch. It is also known as tendinous arch or white line or obturator fascia covering the obturator foramina. So if you see, this is iliococcygeus. It is arising from the, this is pubic symphysis, that means it is the anterior aspect. So it is arising from the anterior aspect of the ischial spine or anterior aspect of coccygeus, also arising from the ischial spine, and this is the obturator fascia. So this is the anterior aspect. So it is arising from the posterior aspect of the obturator fascia. Okay, arising from the posterior aspect of the obturator fascia. This is iliococcygeus. Okay, and this iliococcygeus is inserted into the fibers of both the joint, both the sides, they join together, okay, and they get attached to the anococcygeal ligament or the anococcygeal raphe. Okay, so if you see here, this is the anococcygeal ligament. Between the anal canal and the coccyx, there is one ligament which is known as anococcygeal ligament. Okay, so it will get inserted to the anococcygeal ligament, okay, or the anococcygeal raphe. Okay, so now what happens? Both the sides, the muscle fibers, they join together with the opposite side to form a raphe, which is known as anococcygeal raphe. Okay, so I'll again repeat. Iliococcygeus, it is arising anterior to the coccygeus muscle. Okay, it is arising from the ischial spine, the posterior half of the obturator fascia. This white line you can see, this is the obturator fascia covering the obturators muscle and obturator foramen. So this is the anterior aspect, pubic symphysis, this is the posterior. So this is the obturator fascia, white line or tendinous arch. From the posterior aspect, the iliococcygeus is arising. It goes on both the sides and the fibers get attached to the anococcygeal raphe. Okay, anococcygeal raphe. Okay, from behind. This way and this way, the fibers get attached to the anococcygeal raphe and the anococcygeal junction or ligament. Okay, now what is this anococcygeal raphe? Okay, what is this anococcygeal body or the anococcygeal raphe or anococcygeal ligament? If you see here, the anococcygeal ligament is the fibrous median raphe in the fore of the pelvis, which extends between the coccyx and the margin of the anus. So it extends between the coccyx and the margin of the anus. Okay, so if you see here, if I draw from above, anterior and this is posterior, this is posterior, most anterior is pubic symphysis and most posterior would be sacrum. So in between, the structures are from anterior to posterior, line by line. First is urethra, vagina, then the perineal body and then the anorectal junction. Okay, anorectal junction. Okay, then comes the anococcygeal raphe or the ligament. Okay, so here it is attached. Okay, the iliococcygeus is attached here. And what is anococcygeal raphe? It's a fibrous raphe in the floor of pelvis which extends between the coccyx and the margin of the anus. So it extends between the coccyx and the margins of the anus. So anococcygeal raphe. Okay, or ligament. So here it is attached. Okay, it is inserted. So this is about the origin and insertion of the iliococcygeus muscle. What is the origin? Okay, what is the origin of the iliococcygeus? It is, you can see here, it is iliococcygeus. It is anterior to coccygeus muscle. It is arising from the ischial spine, the posterior half of the white line or obturator fascia or tendinous arch. Okay, posterior aspect, because this is the anterior aspect and this is the posterior aspect. It goes, the fibers on both the sides, they decussate at the anococcygeal raphe or ligament and gets inserted there. Okay, so this was about the iliococcygeus and ischiococcygeus muscle. Okay, in my next video, I will continue with the pubococcygeus and the actions of these muscles. Thank you, students.